I think that we're looking, obviously, to improve upon last season's record. And in conference, we're trying to do a better job of not just getting to the tournament, but also making it to the final game and hoping to win. I think that we've learned a lot through the fall and even so far this spring with preseason. We played some good teams, top-ranked teams in the fall, which has shown us the level we need to be at to compete with the best teams. We open up with Penn State, Dartmouth, and Syracuse, which is, you know, they're all top 20 teams, very tough competition. So, you know, we've been continuing to play hard every day, and, you know, we've learned what we need to do to compete with the best. I think that we're a lot deeper. We're more athletic, skilled, faster than we've ever been. And while I feel we're still a pretty young team, I think that, you know, we're going to be able to rely on a lot of people in our big games, which is great. I think with being a young team, confidence and experience are going to be some things, some hurdles that we're going to have to overcome. But I think that, you know, especially jumping out to, you know, a few really strong games, I think that, you know, we're going to learn as we go and in hopes to get ready for conference play. I think that you're going to expect to see, you know, players like Allie Haig, Meg McDonald, Sarah Buxton, all stepping up in the midfield as well as contributing and scoring for us. You're going to see Sam Stern, Allie Fole, Natalie Jones all stepping up as well in terms of contributing offensively. And you know, I think that there'll be, you know, some freshmen stepping into some starting roles as well, which is exciting. I think that some of them may see some significant time. You know, I think Danielle O'Dwyer's done a great job defensively for us so far this year. So she's going to kind of step into the role of, you know, what Jessa Merrill did for us last year. I think that Bree Conley and Emma Kelly will help in the midfield as well as on attack. And then Taylor Hadcock, our freshman goalkeeper, will likely see time as well in the cage. So I think that, you know, typically it's been the BU and UNH that have been sort of the front runner. And but I think that now the teams have really narrowed the gap, and I expect this season to be the most exciting America East women's lacrosse season yet. And there's also three new head coaches for three of the teams in the America East this year, so it'll be exciting.